Hello and welcome to RC Birds. Today I'm reviewing my Tamiya G601 Konghead. The G601 is an improved GF01 chassis. It has been added for a third driven axle. So as I already said about my Comical Avanti in the RC commentary, this chassis is known as the running gearbox. The G601 chassis is available with the body of the King Yellow school bus, the Konghead, the Volvo A60H dump truck and the Dynahead. The three first ones differ in the body and the stickers. The Dynahead has additional portal access and the chassis is named G601TR. The Volvo has a different mount of the receiver and for the ESC because to the design of the dump bed and a different bumper too. But technical, all four models are the same. Out of the box, the G601 has a six-wheel driven drivetrain. As always, there are no ball bearings in the kit and the model is fitted with friction shocks. Also in the kit are all parts you need to build in the rear wheel steering. Although many Tamiya kits come along with an ESC, there is no one in this kit. On my homepage you find two alternatives which can be used for this car. I put a link in the description of this video. So let's first have a look on the manual. The manual is divided in two parts. The first one is for the chassis build. And you got a second sheet for the body. The manual is clear and easy to understand as always. We start with some notices. Then we got the gearbox and the gears. Three differentials for this car. Go on with the suspension. The building of the friction dampers. And the RC electronics. Battery box. ESC and receiver. Tidying up the wiring, body mounts and wheels, the bumper, and soon we get to the body. Then you need the body sheet, cutting out, painting, put on the stickers, the exhaust pipes and the air intakes, and your car is done. This is a version of the two-wheel steering. If you want the four-wheel steering, you got some additional pages. And the manual closes with some driving informations, the parts list, that's all to say about the manual. Now we get to the model. For my Konghead I got an additional body. The body is made out of polycarbonate. And I had ruined the painting here. So I use this for driving. And in addition, I got it to practice my own building skills as I put on the stock stickers, which take quite a lot of time to cut them out and bring them on easily. my chef, queen, Kong Het. It's some other painting. It's a fat color, like all my big wheelers. And I put on some aftermarket stickers and these roof lights. To the roof lights, I had to say they look great. They can be switched over the radio and they have 5 different modes of flashing. But after a few minutes of running, they stop flashing and stay on. That is not nice, and I didn't use them on later models that I had built. This is a pity because it's a nice feature, but there must be some disadvantage if you buy them for 10 euros only. As you can see, I got these big body clips here. They are not standard. In the kit you have small clips, but I like these big ones. And I've got a lot of them in my toolbox, and it's easier for me to use them. Here is the third channel for the flashing lights. I put it off. And we have a closer look on the chassis. As you can see, I got my standard configuration, which I use for every of my big wheelers except the Cloudbuster. A complete set of ball bearings, effect paint, a sound module, a sport tuned motor, and oil filled shocks. Here you can see one servo, two servo, the sound module, the ESC, the receiver and the power switch. The cables are all tied up, but keep in mind that here is the battery box. And the battery box moves upwards, so you need enough space that you can put in a battery. As you can see, the body is high above on this body mounts. So sometimes the body tends to wobble around. So you can reinforce this by using some pins. They are going through here and through here. And maybe diagonal about the model, but keep in mind you have to change the battery. As you can see on the left side of the car, there are the two servos mounted. The motor hangs out on the right. But I don't get any issue with some obstacles on the ground if I'm driving. The motor never hit them. And as you can see here, from here in the beginning to here in the front, this is a complete gearbox and the complete chassis too. The rest is mounted up on above. The front bumper is cushioned by springs and can be slightly adjusted over the two screws who sit in here, which sit in here, sorry. My technical changes to the car, besides the ball bearings and the motor, are the shocks and the four-wheel steering. The shocks I use are the original hop-ups I use from Tamiya. You have to use the springs that come along with the friction dampers in the kit. Each hop-up set, there are 4 dampers, so you need 2 of the sets, and they are very expensive. At this time, when I built this car, there were no cheaper alternatives. Now we got the comical cars Avanti and Hotshot. Both cars have the same dimensions of the shocks, and they have plastic oil-filled shocks you can use for this kind of chassis. As I said in the beginning of the video, the GF01 chassis, which is used on the comical cars, is the same from the principle as the G601 chassis. You should know that the dampers are slightly different. There's a difference between front and rear. That this is a front damper, this is clear. This is a rear damper, this is clear too. And what this is depends if you put in the steering. If you got the steering, they have the dimensions of the front wheel shocks, front shocks. And if you got no steering in, they are rear wheel shocks. The manual of the hop-up set didn't point out this difference because it's made for a four-wheel car and not for a six-wheel car. A few words about the optional rear wheel steering. All parts for this are in the kit and the steps are shown in the manual. You only need a servo and there are two possibilities. The cheap version is in Y-wire, which support both servos over one channel. That is what I have done to this car, after spending so much money on the oil-filled shocks. This works very good. Tamea constructed the geometry of the steering in that way that the servos don't have to work in the opposite way. But keep in mind that you have a master-slave configuration, and that means the rear is the master. The rear steering doesn't deflect as much as the front steering, so the rear steering determines the steering and the turning radius of the front. So in summary, this means the turning improvement of the four-wheel steering has no effect because the steering of the deflection of the front wheel has decreased. There is another option for the four-wheel steering. You put the rear servo on a third channel and mix it up with the front servo. Here you can put the dual rates for both servos individual and optimize the steering for the car. This decision has every modeler to do for his own. In my mind, the cheap version over one channel with a Y wire works very good. This is a fun car and I do not want to do shunting maneuvers with it. Unfortunately for the G601 chassis, there are not many tuning parts available, because this model is made for beginners in the hobby. If you want to increase the speed a little bit, you could put in a faster motor or change the pinion gear from 18T to 20T. For Shelf Queen fans, there is a clear gray chassis box available, complete with colored gears. I think orange, red, yellow. I thought about it, but I used a lot of grease in my gears, so it might be look a little creepy after a few runs and I let it. In summary, the cars of the G601 family are fun models. Tamea says that they can cope with an incline up to 40 degrees, but they are no crawlers. These cars are made for fun driving on dirt tracks, throwing dust around, doing little show with their rear steering, and that's all. The lightweighted body gives a very low center of gravity. Therefore, jumps are no problems. But do not expect to fly high in the sky. It is more of landing on wheels when you are driving over the edge of a jump. I like my Kong head. It's easy to drive and less to maintain because of the gearbox chassis style. And it also has a good appearance in the shelf. Only the battery changes are annoying for me. They are pretty easy, no doubt, but I personally do not like to remove the body for the battery change. But this is my personal opinion and not a problem of the car. So if you got some questions, write it down in the comments. In the description, you find a link to the shopping resources for this car and some of the parts I used for my model. And as always, like, subscribe and do not forget to hit the bell, so you don't miss the next upcoming video on this channel. See you soon on our seabirds. And now my birds need time for me.